Hey guys, Bonk here. After Min Min launched as the debut character in Fighters Pass Volume 2, many expectations had been lowered for what to expect from the future of DLC. Would we continue receiving these sometimes obscure first-party Nintendo characters? Certainly the bar had been set a bit too high by Joker. But on October 1st, Sakurai came to us with an unbelievable announcement. As we now know, Steve from Minecraft, along with costumes of Alex, Zombie, and Enderman, was confirmed as the next DLC fighter. If you aren't hovering around Twitter and Reddit communities too often, Steve has been talked about as a Smash fighter for quite a while. Thing is, he was almost exclusively referred to in a meme-y matter, with very few people actually considering him as a legitimate possibility. From his initial words, it seemed as though even Sakurai himself was surprised that Steve in Smash was actually real.
But he pulled it off! Yet again, Sakurai delivered and created an incredibly unique fighter that remains faithful to a Source game very different from Smash. Minecraft needs no introduction, but needless to say, it isn't a fighting game. Sure, it does have its share of combat, but Minecraft's core gameplay is based around farming for materials and building structures, sometimes for art, other times for survival. If you want to survive the next zombie attack, subscribe to Pro Guides before it's too late. In Smash, Steve is still focused on mining for materials and building blocks, although he'll be fighting opponents with his sword and tools at the same time. Gathering materials doesn't just allow him to create blocks, though. Like in Minecraft, Steve can craft upgraded versions of his tools and weapons, as well as minecarts and the explosive TNT. The availability of these options and the need to farm materials to keep them available makes Steve an incredibly complex and overwhelming character to fully grasp, especially this early on. Fortunately, it doesn't take a galaxy brain to recognize that Steve is a combo machine. Even so soon after the character's release, players are discovering huge, practical true combos left and right. While many other trap and setup-based characters dread being in close proximity to their opponents, Steve has some ridiculous frame data on his normals that give him tons of combo and pressure opportunities. Many of these sequences will put his opponent off stage, where he can prepare a variety of dangerous edgeguarding and ledge-trapping setups. The result is a character who, when optimized, will have opportunities to turn many low-percent interactions into a KO. In this video, we're gonna dig deeper into Steve's combo and setup potential to get a glimpse of what this character's metagame might look like in a few months. For our question of the day, how viable do you think Steve is? Will he be the next DLC top tier or fall into DLC mid-tier hell? Or the Nether, in his case. Let us know in the comments and stay tuned to see what this character is already capable of. To learn even more about Steve and everything Smash, log on to ProGuides.com. Our website offers multiple benefits, such as live coaching available anytime through InstaPro, pro courses taught by the best of the best like MKLeo himself, and live stream classes where you can play with pros. Check out ProGuides.com today. When it comes to combos, Steve has two obvious starter moves, jab and up tilt. It might be more accurate to refer to these as sword and axe, because both double as ground attacks and aerials. Steve's jab can be used while standing, walking, or in the air, giving him continued control over his movement during the attack. This is extremely rare, kind of like a diamond, for a grounded attack, and combined with its frame data makes for a great pressure tool in neutral. Technically, the sword is a jab, forward tilt, nair, and even a form of back air. Buffering a forward or back air will give you the sword swing, which is essentially a nair, but buffering a back air will reverse the direction of the nair with an animation more similar to back airs. The real point here is that you can perform a sword swing just about anywhere, anytime, and this is really good considering the frame data on this move. The sword comes out on frame 4, or frame 3 for the gold version, and has an incredibly early FAF of frame 16, or 14 for gold. This just means that it's a really fast move with really low cooldown. You can use it anywhere, and it's as easy as holding A to spam it repeatedly. That sounds pretty broken, but what happens when you actually hit someone with it? Yep, that happens. This move combos into itself at early percents quite well. This works for all variants, but the Diamond Sword combos even more reliably. As Mewtwo King has showcased, a jab string at low percents can link into a ferret ledge, which spikes. Now, the fair spike isn't too strong, especially at low percents, but the key thing here is that it puts your opponent off stage below the ledge. This is prime time for Steve. For starters, recoveries without hitboxes are easily blocked. Oh, you think stepping on a Lego hurts? Yeah. Try banging your head into one. A single block placed in the path of many recoveries is enough to gimp them, even thwarting teleport recoveries if placed right near the ledge. This isn't hard to do either. Steve can simply place a block right by the ledge after swinging his fair. Standing on the block will make it break faster, but Steve can repeatedly create more blocks in the same spot by standing on it and holding B. This allows him to easily refresh the trap against opponents who stall. Now, many recoveries will still eat through Steve's block and grab the ledge, but this doesn't get them out of the pixelated woods yet. In these matchups, Steve can opt to prepare the ledge trap setup of his choice. From the position after going for a jab to fair spike, he can jump back onto stage and prepare a block to interrupt ledge jumps, traditionally one of the harder options to cover. He may instead opt for a TNT placed near the ledge. If the opponent has a slower recovery, he may even have time for both. From here, there's plenty of potential for Steve to catch his opponent's getup option with a jab, up tilt, minecart, which can explode the TNT and is also a command grab, or even a grab. The potential for ledge trap setups could be an entire video itself, but let's not forget that he can also opt for some traps before the opponent even grabs the ledge. Dropping a down air or TNT on top of the opponent is always an option, or he could sit on stage and drop down tilts. Down tilt can be negated by some recoveries though, so it isn't a be-all end-all edgeguard. This has all been framed from the perspective of completing a sequence after going for jab strings into fair offstage, but these edgeguard and ledge trap tools are useful any chance he gets to use them. The sword jab can even be confirmed out of down throw at low percents, but it isn't just good in the early range. At higher percents, a sword swing can lead into situational kill confirms into back air or forward air as well. Oh, and it's pretty safe on shield too. With good execution, jab can even convert into a fair spike on stage to set up for another jab. This could lead to lots of damage at mid percents, or in the right situation, could create extended combos ending in kill confirms. As great as jab is for combos, it may not even be Steve's best combo tool. This brings us to his rapid axe attack, which doubles as his up tilt and up air. Like jab, the axe is also really fast, starting on frame 6 or frame 4 for the gold variant. If you land one of these at low percents, your opponent is going for a ride. Up tilt easily combos into itself, then into up airs, which Steve can even extend with a well-placed block. Relatively consistent 0 to 60% combos are possible with this move. At mid percents, all the way up to kill percents, the incredibly low end lag on up tilt allows it to combo into a forward air, back air, or even up smash. All three of these are guaranteed kill confirms at the appropriate percents. What's great about the sword and axe is that they're very capable even with the weaker materials. Upgrading to iron or even diamond will increase the damage output with similar or sometimes better combo potential, and finishers like forward and back air are stronger with diamond too. With what we know now, these two attacks are Steve's best combo tools and can lead to crazy amounts of damage or even stocks if optimized properly. They aren't his only combo starters though. As we mentioned, down throw is a decent combo throw. The easiest setup is a dash attack, but it can link into dash jab as well, and sometimes even a forward air. Side B has some combo potential too. The minecart, when Steve jumps out, is a command grab, and a pretty good one too given how long it takes to mash out. If the positioning is right, Steve can chase the minecart and combo the opponent out of it. Since the minecart is moving away, this increases the likelihood of the opponent being near ledge, so spike KOs are possible. If not, just another edgeguard opportunity. So where does the future of Steve's optimization lie? Well, there's obviously a ton to take into account in terms of blocking off parts of the stage and farming, but in terms of combos, jab loops look like the future. Not only can a grounded jab combo into a forward air spike, but grounded jab can combo into a rising nair, which sets up for a falling fair spike. This can lead into more jabs and let Steve carry an opponent to the ledge from almost any distance. It seems likely that there will be an abundance of setups into offstage fair spikes, which are deadly even at low percents to characters with recoveries that lose to blocks.
Twitter is overflowing with new discoveries all the time, and we can't wait to see what people find next. Make sure to subscribe to Pro Guides for continued updates on the future of competitive Smash. Thanks for watching, guys.